there's a line, I cross it. I ain't lost it, run this shit. I bossed and floss a marathon, so caution. Knocks will leave you nauseous. Knocks is hot, I reap a sauces. Toxins drop to fiends in office. I don't mean to be this heartless. Fuck the club and diamonds, I bring spades and coffins.
I've been feeling like I ain't high yet. Still I'm on this jet, back in mileage. They tell me no my role or get silence. Whoa, I'm a survivor.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free ghost. Just don't be surprised if he vanishes on you. What's going on, YouTube? It's Noxil, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, man, it is Thursday, aka Mathers Day. And listen, we got a very, very special one today. We got a track I've never checked out before. It's none other than Eminem. It's none other than Kendrick Lamar. This right here is Love Game. But before getting further, I'm going to give a quick shout out to the song in the intro. Listen, if you guys like that, yes, I'm a rapper myself. There's a good chance to like my breakdowns. But I think about music, you'll probably like my music as well. That is a brand new track. It's dropped over 100K streams on Spotify, smashing records right now. I'm very, very proud of it, guys. You want to support me, support the channel directly. I'll put the links to that below. Also, shout out to the Patreon, Patreon family, exclusive reactions and content on there. Again, you want to support, all links down there. But anyways, we know what we're here for. Eminem, Kendrick Lamar. I live for days like this, man. Step up to the plate. See what you got.
Something's burning, I can't figure out what. It's either lust or a cloud of dust. Judgment is clouded, must just be the powder from the power.
What is that sample?
But I'm in something I don't know how to get out of. Left my girl in the house alone.
Hang on. Oh yeah, Wayne Fontana and the Mindbenders. How could I forget? That was a great year to be born. A Game of Love. I didn't just look that up. All right, let's get back into this.
Something's burning, I can't figure out what. It's either lust or a cloud of dust. Judgment is clouded, must just be the powder from the power of love. But I'm in something I don't know how.
Judgment is clouded, must be the powder from the power of love. I mean, what is that rhyme scheme? He starts with the us sound, right? And then it goes into the O vowel scheme, the our, outer sound. And then it goes back into the U sound. So he goes U to O to you. Starts the line with the rhyme, ends the line on that rhyme, and then has that multi-syllable internal O scheme right before that ending. That was A-B-A within a bar. Then the next bar went A-B-A. That was very, very good rhyme writing already.
Cloud of dust, judgment. Something's burning, I can't figure out what. It's either lust or a cloud of dust. Judgment is clouded, must just...
Lust or a cloud of dust. Judgment is clouded, must. See how he hits judgment? Instead of connecting that, he highlights and emphasizes the judge to fit it in with the love, to fit it in with those sounds, and then carries on the scheme. And then we got some drug scheme going on.
I can't figure out what. It's either lust or a cloud of dust. Judgment is...
Right, something is burning. I can't figure out what is. Is this love burning? Like, is our romance burning? Or is it maybe just drugs burning in a cloud of dust? Or is he likening drugs to sort of an addiction as he's done before on tracks like 25 to Life? On all of his just relationships that turn into obsessions, that turn into addictions gone wrong.
Something's burning, I can't figure out what. It's either lust or a cloud of dust. Judgment is clouded, must just be the powder from the power of love. But I'm in something I don't know how to get.
Must just be the powder, right? Power, taking powder lines there. But also, it's not just that. We're buzzing off of a thing called love. Put that in your pipe and smoke.
Out of dust, judgment is clouded, must just be the powder from the power of love. But I'm in something I don't know how to get out of. Left my girl in the house alone.
Is that
my soon to be spouses?
Low.
And the further I walk, the louder. Pause for a minute to make certain that's what I heard. Cause after all, this is her place, so I give her the benefit of the doubt. I
think I might be about to
muster.
The thoughts carry yo, though, when it hurts.
Brace,
hope it ain't.
Here we go, yo.
Cause my head already goes the worst
case scenario, though, in the first place.
No, he just did he just pull out Busta Rhymes and Tribe Called Quest scenario? Here we go, yo. Here we go, yo. What's the scenario? Oh man. And I love the way that he did that because he took his doubles and he took his ad-libs and he stacked them. So it's like crowd chanting. And that's exactly how the doubles and the ad-libs sound in that classic Tribe Called Quest song itself. And he, man, the storytelling ability, though, because he's in the middle of telling a story, and somehow he takes a moment to fit this in, to pay homage to a classic song and sample, while at the same time working it into his schemes. I mean, the writing on that, man.
The doubter.
I think I might be about to
muster.
The thoughts carry yo, though, when it...
And then he might be about to bust. Like, he's going to bust her because he hears something as he's leaving. Maybe she's creeping on him, or maybe he's going to bust in a different way. And then the third way that drops in is obviously him shouting out Busta Rhymes, and now Busta is introduced. Busta Busta on the track.
Wait, so I give her the benefit of the doubt.
I think I might be about to
Busta Busta.
The thought's scary, yo, though, when it hurts.
Brace,
hope it ain't.
Here we go, yo.
Because my head already goes the worst
case scenario, though, when...
I mean, even like right there, it goes to worst case scenario. So the one meeting is literally like his head's going to the worst case scenario because he thinks something's happened. He thinks that she's creeping on him. But at the same time, the scenario also means literally the title of that Tribe Called Quest track scenario. And then it's delivered in the way that it's delivered within the scenario track itself. The layers to that. And then that it hurts, brace, like brace for the moment. But also like if you get hurt, you might need a brace if you've broken something.
Brace, hope it ain't, here we go, yo. Cause my head already goes the worst case scenario, though in the first place. But you confirm my low end theory, though. Should've known when I made it all the way to third base. And that was only the first game.
Fuck, what is happening already, man? Oh, I'm enjoying this too damn much right now. Tribe Called Quest, Low End Theory. I was just bumping Midnight Marauders the other day and thinking, man, I need to get back to some Low End Theory. So right there, he drops it. The Tribe Called Quest album, Low End Theory. So we're paying further homage. Then we're also paying homage to Third Base. And if y'all don't know about Third Base, Third Base had a track that they featured an artist at the time who became one of the greatest MCs of hip-hop. I'm talking about none other than MF Doom. But then it goes even further, right? Because Low End Theory. Think about what's on the low end. The bass is on the low end. B-A-S-S. Like musically, sonically, the bass on the low end. But also rounding third base in terms of sexual schemes and what's going on. He got around first. He's made out. He's gotten a second. Copped a feel. And then third, he carries on that scheme. So you got the baseball sexual scheme. And then you got the sonic bass scheme while all tying in with low end theory of Tribe Called Quest.
Insane. From my low end theory though. Should have known when I made it all the way to third. And that was only the first game. Could have made it the whole plate. But you slid straight for the dome and go first. No, you don't understand. I don't do this for anyone ever. Yeah, that ain't what they all say.
Oh, man. I love how obviously fellatio is then happening. He's getting head right there. And in between sucking off M, she's getting out the different words. I don't ever do this for anybody. And then M's like, yeah, okay, keep telling yourself that. And obviously, rounding home, but in this case, instead of rounding home, Eminem is sliding into the plate, sliding for the dome, going home, but also dome because he's getting head, he's getting domed up.
I don't do this for anyone ever. Yeah, that ain't what they all say, I'll say. You can suck a softball through a straw, used to be my fiance.
Oh, wow. And then the first date scheme goes even further because obviously he's taking her home to do this. Get it? Like he's taking her back to his crib to get it on, but then also baseball rounding, hitting a home run, getting all the way around to home.
Yeah, that ain't what they all say, I'll say. You can suck a softball through a straw. Used to be my fiance. So you sucked up.
I mean, damn, that's impressive. Sucking a softball through a straw, but also you could go like straw, softball, dick to balls.
Ain't what they all say, I'll say. You can suck a softball through a straw. Used to be my fiance. So you sucked on Wayne, Andre, and Kanye. LeBron, Akon, Jay, Little John, Raekwon, Mace, Polo to Don Drake, Dante, Ross, James, Conway.
Don Drake, Dante, Raekwon, Mace. Again, wow. How did M always does this now? Like, I'm still impressed how he can just take like a list of names and find like that internal rhyme scheme. So it's the Aeon, 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 Aeon. And the way that he enunciates stuff, the way that he pauses and breaks apart names, he is literally hitting that A to on scheme in between it all. Andre and Kanye, LeBron, Akon, Jay, Lil Jon, Ray. What? Come on.
Yeah, LeBron, Akon, Jay, Lil Jon, Raekwon, Mace, Paul.
I mean, we got some greats in there. Andre, three stacks. And again, you're talking about top MCs of all time. I got Tribe up there. I got Andre in there. Jay's in there, Raekwon.
Don, Drake, Dante, Ross, James, Conway, Kwame.
I mean, too bad Drake doesn't rap anymore. I'm just kidding. Sorry, Drake fans, but I'm not sorry.
Con Jay, Little John, Raekwon, Mace, Polo, Don, Drake, Dante, Ross, James, Conway, Kwame. Guess I'm getting my good.
Kwame? He's not talking about Kwame, that fucking Detroit mayor that got all those RICO charges and went away. The corrupt ass Detroit mayor. I think he is. I think he is. I think because obviously he's shouting out, you know, different contributors to the culture, right? Polo the Don, great producer, shouting out Drake, Dante Ross, director, Conway the Machine, and then Kwame, like, that's why he says, like, Kwame? Like, he's like, hang on, that doesn't really fit in this list, but hey, she's sucking off everybody, so she's getting around.
Bass Polo to Don, Drake, Dante Ross, James Conway, Kwame! Guess I'm getting my goddamn jigger on, eh? Cause your name I'm Beyonce, but fuck it.
When he said jigga, chicka chicka chicka, he did his little Slim Shady, chicka 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 chicka, Slim Shady, brain dead like Jim Brady.
So I'm getting my good goddamn.
And then obviously Jigga, another name for Jay-Z.
On A, cause your name I'm Beyonce, but fuck it, I'm moving on, you women are all crack.
Cause your name I'm Beyonce. How do you think like that? How do you just go, yo, I'm gonna take Beyonce's name and I'm going to totally slant rhyme the shit out of it and make a homophone bend happen in that way, because that's literally what he just did there. The Jay-Z to Beyonce scheme, but your name is Beyonce because you're sleeping around with all these dudes.
And you're on A, because your name is Beyonce.
How?
But fuck it, I'm moving on. You women are all crack, but I'll probably always keep on playing.
And I just realized the whole baseball scheme ties in with the theme of the song and the sample that they've taken it from, Game of Love, because literally he was playing a baseball game going around the bases, which ties in with Game of Love.
I'm moving on, you women are all crack, but I'll probably always keep on playing the game of love.
She doesn't love me.
Okay, Kendrick.
No, she don't love me no more. She hates my company. Yes, she don't love me no more.
That's smooth.
I tried to get her up out of my head, left my bags at the door. She screams,
get up out of my head. I love the way that he just holds that out. Take him to church, Kendrick.
Tried to get up out of my bed, left my bags at the door. She screams,
man, it's got like that nostalgic classic swing to it, you know? Old school rock, but bring it into the world of hip hop, man. This is dope. Who's producing this? Someone's got a comment.
Out of my bed, left my bags at the door. She screams, she loved me like she never did before. And I told her, I told that bitch,
I'm a sucker for love, you a sucker for dick. Sucking dick in your mama tub, then your granny walked in, told the stupid nigga to duck under the water. He drowned like an abortion. They booked you for manslaughter. You beat the case and I caught you.
Oh man. Oh, you don't want to get caught by mama, so you tell him to dip down a grandma's sub, and he was down there so long, the dumbass drowned. And then he relates that to an abortion bar, an abortion scheme. Only Kendrick's twisted mind can go there in the middle of storytelling. It's a very shady type of thing. And you know what? Honestly, like, I'm sat here thinking, like, Kendrick compared to Shady, two very different styles, honestly, very different approaches. I know Kendrick says he admires them, he was inspired by M, but very different approaches to MCing, definitely, like 100%. So I'm like, how are they gonna come together on the track like this? And it makes sense. I didn't even think about this. Kendrick, a great storyteller. Eminem, a great storyteller as well. Let's make a storytelling track.
Nigga to duck under the water, he drowned like an abortion. They booked you for manslaughter. You beat the case and I caught you.
Sharan is not a...
They booked you for manslaughter, like you're killing babies, but in this case, he's a grown-ass man, so they're booking you for slaughtering this man.
Duck under the water, he drowned like an abortion. They booked you for manslaughter. You beat the case and I caught you.
Sharan is not available. Now leave a message at the tone. And Kendrick, don't forget to buy to bear those expensive...
We're shouting out Sheree. Kendrick is going again. You talk about nostalgia and going back in the day to Kendrick's debut and Sheree.
Sheree is not available. Now leave a message at the tone. And Kendrick, don't forget to buy to bear those expensive heels. You little fucking Ferris wheel. Fucking spinning on me. Fuck you think we gonna get married.
Fucking Ferris wheel. Fucking spending on me. But also spinning like a Ferris wheel. The way that he says it. Ben spinning with spending. And I love this. I love this flow right here.
Manslaughter. You beat the case and I caught you.
Sharan is not available. Now leave a message at the tone. And Kendrick, don't forget to buy to bear those expensive heels. You little fucking Ferris wheel. Fucking spinning on me. Fuck you think we gonna get married still. Fucking Mary had a little lamb. This ain't a fairy tale. Fairy guy.
Fuck you spending on me, fucking Ferris wheel. Like, there's no breathing right there. It's just a very cool pocket, and he's doubting the multi-syllable rhyme schemes in between the harder percussive hits, but it's a very just ride it through type of delivery on this shit.
Fuck you spending on me, fuck you think we gonna get married still. Fucking Mary had a little lamb.
And then Mary had a little lamb, but in this case, he was fucking Mary, so she literally had a little lamb, and then it ties back in with the abortion scheme.
Feels your little fucking Ferris wheel. Fucking spending on me, fuck you think we gonna get married still. Fucking Mary.
We got Roe v. Wade bars. Too soon? Yeah, definitely too
soon. Those expensive heels, you little fucking Ferris wheel. Fucking spinning on me. Fuck you think we gon' get married still. Fucking Mary had a little lamb. This ain't a fairy tale. Fairy god. Mama better tell you how I fucking feel. Like you should fucking beat it or fucking eat it while I'm on my period. Now have a blessed day.
Bitch, you serious? I'm in the mirror.
Right. You ain't fucking with me. You cut me up. You cut them deep, but also when you have a C-section, when you have a cesarean, you go in and you cut it out. And in this case, he was cut up prematurely. And then the thing that got me was just the beautiful, romantic, poetic visuals of a girl being on her period and you having the absolute pleasure of just numbing all over that shit. Yeah, okay. We're done there.
Beat it or fucking eat it while I'm on my period. Now have a blessed day.
Bitch, you serious? I'm in the mirror with this. Look on my face, curious. Why you ain't fucking with me? You cut me deep as a Syrian. You know I want you bad as a Benjamin. I'm delirious. I want you...
Wait, what did I do here?
A blessed day.
Bitch, you serious? I'm in the mirror with...
Okay. Oh, man. I'm not editing this. I don't care. I try not to ever edit these reactions. I try to just push right through it. But obviously, this is me like cheating because I'm sat here looking ahead and I see the cesarean lines, but he hasn't even delivered the cesarean lines yet. So I'm one step ahead. Damn you. Why did I have to? I picked the lyric video because the problem is normally when I take the normal videos, I get copyright issues and I'm not dealing with fucking copyright today. So I'm like, you know what? I'll just grab something that's already been cleared because I have a case for it and then I ain't got to deal with it.
Get a fucking eat it while I'm on my period and I have a blessed day.
Bitch, you serious? I'm in the mirror with this look on my face. Curious why you ain't fucking with me. You cut me deep as a Syrian. You know I want you bad as a Benjamin. I'm delirious. I want you bad as the head shattered on George Zimmerman. After the Dillinger hit him diligently and killing him.
After the Dillinger hit him diligently and killing him, I want you bad as the head shattered on George Zimmerman. George Zimmerman, Trayvon Martin. And that tragedy right there, George Zimmerman murdered Trayvon. Got away with it. Essentially, still no justice for that to this day.
Yes, I want you bad as the head shattered on George Zimmerman. After the Dillinger hit him diligently and killing him.
And obviously, I want you as bad as Benjamin. I take that as like all for the Benjamins, like doing it for the money.
I'm delirious. I want you bad as the head shattered on George Zimmerman. After the Dillinger hit him diligently and killing him. His mouthpiece for a Cadillac emblem. That's analogy and metaphor.
Mouthpiece for a Cadillac emblem. And the way that he says emblem, he's like emblem. So he can fit it in with the Dillinger diligently in the way that he's just like rolling over, like cascading some of those words so they fall over top of each other. That's a smooth delivery. I take that as like the grill of a Cadillac. Like he wants to fuck up his head, smash in his face, smash in his grill. Get it? Cadillac emblem sits on the grill, relates to the grill, getting all up in
diligently
the grill.
Diligently killing him. His mouthpiece for a Cadillac emblem.
That's an analogy and metaphor for you.
Right. That was not as well explained as it should have been. Mouthpiece. Right? Like when you get a grill, your mouthpiece, get it? Cadillac, grills on a Cadillac, grills like a mouthpiece, a piece in your mouth.
You're killing them, it's mouthpiece for a Cadillac emblem.
That's an analogy and metaphor for you. I should win a metaphor, all the ways I adore you. This is me.
That's a very clever just word flip right there. That's analogy and metaphor for you. I should win a medal for you. The way he says metaphor sounds like metaphor. That's, man, I love the way that Kendrick thinks about rhymes and puts them together into schemes. And then obviously he just made an extended metaphor. You know, how bad he wants you? As bad as he wants to smash in George Zimmerman's face.
That's an analogy and metaphor for you. I should win a metaphor. All the ways I adore you. This is me talking cordial. Yeah, I got some home training. That ain't what you like, ain't it? What about if I was famous as Marshall? What you get fellatio in the carpool? Cops pull us over. They just want to know if you gargle. See,
I hope she's good enough.
Shit.
Meanwhile, you're chasing her.
Chlamydia couldn't even get rid of her. Pity the fool and pity the fool in me. I'ma live with the game
up. I pity the fool. We going Mr. T on some shit now. But chlamydia couldn't even get rid of her. You get that clap. See, you can't get rid of that chlamydia that easily. You know what I'm saying?
Chlamydia couldn't even get rid of her. Pity the fool in me. I'ma live with the.
You can take that in two ways. One, like, he's always got her memory because he got chlamydia from her. But also, it could be that even if I had chlamydia, she's such a whore getting around, sleeping with everybody, she wouldn't really care. So she'll just. You get a clap today.
Chlamydia couldn't even get rid of her. Pity the fool in me. I'ma live with the.
She doesn't love me.
I never thought we could take such a smooth song and just twist the shit out of it and dedicate it to rap.
No, she don't.
But I love
me no more. She hates my company. Yeah, she don't love me no more.
Is that Eminem doing like some of the lows and bassier stuff? She don't love me no more. There's like something that's really bassy in the bass.
She hates my company. Yeah, she don't love me no more. I tried to get her up out of my head. Left my bags at the door. She screamed she loved me like she never did before. And I told her.
Sam feeling betrayed, snatched my house key off a keychain. She jumps off WeeBay from the wire's dick. Now she's chasing me with a cheese grater. He goes that
WeeBay from the wire? Alright, man, shout out to The Wire, one of the greatest shows of all time. You know, The Wire takes place down the road, people in B-more, Body More, Baltimore. You know what I'm saying? MD people, MD love in the building. So WeeBay from The Wire, right? So she jumped off WeeBay from The Wire, so she was on his dick now, someone else that she's getting around with, and then she's chasing him with a cheese grater. And I take that as that's ironic because she obviously only wants to try to get the cheese and get the money. So now she's chasing him around the house violently with a cheese grater. And then also there's a character Cheese who was also in
betrayed,
The Wire.
Snatched my house key off a keychain. She jumps off WeeBay from The Wire's dick. Now she's chasing me with a cheese grater. He goes that broken record cliche. It's all my fault anyway. She's turning the tables. I'm a B-break. She treats my face like Serato.
broken record, like round and round, we repeat the cycle like a broken record, but then the broken record ties in with a DJ scheme, right? She's turning the tables, she's flipping the odds, flipping the tables. Now she's in control again when he thought he was in control. He's a beat break, and then break beating, you know, again, DJing type of music, break beats, playing off of that, treats my face like Serato's. Oh no, I think I'm getting ahead again.
Here goes that broken record cliche, it's all my fault anyway. She's turning the tables, I'm a beat break. She treats my face like Serato, she cuts and scratches like a DJ. Each day is an instant replay, they say.
Cause she still got the motherfucking cheese grater. I mean, the storytelling on this with the punchlines, you gotta love it, man. Chef's kiss to that shit, and I know it ties in with the cheese grater indeed, people. So she's slashing it, right? Cutting it up, but also you talk about tracks, like we call tracks cuts, right? Like a cut from an album, aka a track from an album, a DJ cutting and scratching. She's cutting and scratching him with his nails and Serato's DJ equipment, turntables. It all ties in. I'm
off from the wise dick. Now she's chasing me with a cheese grater. He goes that broken record cliche. It's all my fault anyway. She's turning the tables. I'm a beat break. She treats my face like Serato. She cuts and scratches like a DJ. Each day is an instant replay. They say what we.
She cuts and scratches like a DJ. Each day is an instant replay. He's got a nice DJ, EJ, replay, do-do-do-do-do. He's got that nice 1-2 tap.
Tables,
man.
I'm a beat break. She treats my face like Serato. She cuts and scratches like a DJ. Each day is an instant replay. They say what we display, symptomatic, erratic behavior. Back together.
What the fuck? Who did these lyrics? Symptomatic? Symptomatic, dipshit.
Like a DJ. Each day is an instant replay. They say what we display, symptomatic, erratic behavior.
There's no such word as erratic. I'm sorry. Merriam-Webster just canceled your ass. It's just got obviously going to be erratic
cuts
behavior.
Cuts and scratches like...
How can you mess that up?
DJ's day is an instant replay. They say what we display, symptomatic of addict behavior. Back together.
Right, it's symptomatic of addict behavior because, again, he's relating all of this love to being like a drug, right? And be... You're fucking kidding me. Hang on. Hang on.
Today was her B-day. She cut me off on the freeway. Simple misunderstanding. But just as I went to slam on the brakes, that's when I realized that she may be crazy as me. Wait, bitch, cut my fucking brake line. Stepped on them fuckers 8 times. Still going 73. Thank God there's an exit coming up.
Oh my God. No.
Wait, she's turning the tables. I'm a beat break. She treats my face.
You're fucking kidding me. This is... Why you gotta do this to me? Like, shit like this is gonna make me end up in Shaq's toilet with Ja Rule. I swear to God. This whole fucking song is an extended metaphor for hip-hop. He just 25 to life us, didn't he? He did. He just did. He did. And it all makes sense now. This is the love-hate, love game that he plays with the game of hip-hop. And this goes even further because we're talking about his life. So he's talking about, you know, love being like a drug and him being like an addict because they repeat the same broken record. See how the DJ scheme, the turntable scheme, all that ties in with hip hop, right? And then the addict scheme relating love to a drug, him being like an addict, right? Also ties in with him literally being an addict at one point in time. And literally, you know, you could take it as like the music and hip hop and all the pressure and everything drove him to try drugs, drove him to be an addict. And drove him round and round that cycle that he ended up breaking and came back to hip hop at the end of it all. Because Eminem did try to quit. He did try to walk away. He tried to retire. And then he's come back. And now there's talk of him retiring again. So it's like a love, hate, in and out. Just like this twisted, fucked up relationship. This is a greater metaphor for hip hop. Kendrick did it too. What am I doing?
Sam feeling betrayed. Snatched my house key off a keychain. She jumps off eBay from the wires kick. Now she's chasing me with a cheese grater. He goes that broken record cliche. It's all my fault anyway. She's turning the table.
All makes sense now.
She treats my face like Serato. She cuts and scratches like a DJ. Each day is an instant replay. They say what we display symptoms. Automatic, erratic behavior, back together, but forgot today was her B-day. She cut me off on the freeway.
Again, back together.
Misunderstanding, but just as I went to slam on.
Because he's gotten back together with rap since then. This is obviously, what is this? Marshall Mathers LP 2 days. Yeah, so he's come back now. He's come out of being an addict. He's come out of checking himself into rehab.
Together, but forgot today was her B-day. She cut me off on the freeway. Simple misunderstanding, but just as I went to slam on the brakes, that's when I realized that she may be crazy as me. Wait, bitch, cut my fucking brake line. Stepped on them fuckers 8 times. Still going 73, thank God there's an exit coming up. For the mother F-U-C-K's wrong, would've hit the off-ramp. Psychosis to a gosh damn hall. And I realized that she may be crazy as me. Wait, bitch, cut my fucking brake line. Stepped on them fuckers 8 times. Still going...
Right, me wait 8 times, break lines, and then he takes F-U-C-K, like just the way that he hits that 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, he still really is hitting out of that 1-2, 1-2, aggressive delivery, 1-2 style rhyme.
73, thank God, there's an exit coming up.
Three, thank.
The F-U-C-K's wrong with a hit.
CK again.
Off ramps, I coast into a goddamn hard hit a fucking tree. Now here she comes at full speed, she's racing at me. Okay, you wanna fuck with me, eh?
Snaps a bitch out of car through the window, she's screaming. I body slam on the cement until the concrete gave and created a sinkhole. Buried the stinkhole in it, then paid to have the street repaired.
Sinkhole, buried the stinkhole in it. Like I pointed out, Kendrick Lamar's metaphor. I really like the way that those rhymes were bent and written.
Slam on the cement until the concrete gave and created a sinkhole. Buried the stinkhole in it, then paid to have the street repaved. Woke up in a dream state in a cold sweat, like I got hit with a freeze ray during a heat wave. Yes, I.
What the? Only Eminem's my man. He rips her out of the window, right? Pushes her down into a sinkhole, then gets them to repay the street over top of it so we can hide the evidence. And then actually, we're in a dream sequence because you're like, man, this is getting ridiculous now. Like, she cut his brakes, he crashed into a tree. Somehow she's driving her car at him and he rips her out of the window. No, now he's dreaming. And then woke up in a dream state in a cold sweat. Waking up in cold sweats and shivers still replays to that attic scheme and the attic bars still tying in with our extended metaphor. And then it goes further, like he got hit with a freeze ray during a heat wave, because if it's hot as shit, you're going to be sweating. But if you got hit with a freeze ray, then it's gonna be a cold sweat.
I got my body slammed on the cement until the concrete gave and created a sinkhole. Buried the stinkhole in it, then paid to have the street repaved. Woke up in a dream state in a cold sweat, like I got hit with a freeze ray during a heat wave. Yes, I eventually caved though, because she's laying next to me in bed directly.
Eventually cave. What does a sinkhole do? A sinkhole caves, but also he caved. He finally gave in. I mean,
I got hit with a freeze ray.
It's a nice extended metaphor.
During a heat wave, yes, I eventually caved though, cause she's laying next to me in bed. Directly aiming again at my head. Woke up again and jumped up like fuck it, I've had it. I'm checking into rehab, I confess I'm a static addict. I guess that's why I'm so clingy. Every girl I've ever had either says I got too much baggage or I'm too.
I've had it, I've checked into rehab, I confess I'm a static addict. I guess that's why I'm so clingy. I love that. He gets like, remember that Kendrick Lamar flow? When he didn't breathe and he just started like getting out in front of that beat and just punching in between pockets. Eminem is doing that. He's doing like that machine gun delivery right there. And no, I'm not talking about machine gun.
I confess I'm a static addict. I guess that's why I'm so clingy. Every girl I've ever had either says I got too much baggage. Ooh. Or I'm too fucking dramatic. Man, what the fuck is the matter? I'm just a fucking romantic. I fucking love you, you fucking bitch. Combative, possessive. In fact, last time I was mad at an ex, I actually set off the chain reaction. A tragic event. I said hit the road. And after she left, I sent that bitch a text. I said, be careful driving. Don't read this and have an accident. She glanced to look at it.
Eminem's shady, twisted mind, right? Sends her off, hit the road. Like, this saying, hit the road. But she took it literally. Like, she hit the road, started driving. So then Eminem sends her a text. Don't read this, it's not safe for you. Obviously, she read it and then she crashes. I mean,
and after she left, I sent that bitch a text. I said, be careful driving, don't read this and have an accident. She glanced a little. I said, hit the road.
But what I love too is combative, possessive. I fucking love you, you fucking bitch. See how he's going from one extreme to another, much in the same way that addicts go from extreme highs to extreme lows. In this case, Eminem with this love, with this relationship, extreme highs to extreme highs in the game and extreme lows.
Baby. After she left, I sent that bitch a text. I said, be careful driving, don't read this and have an accident. She glanced to look at it and wrecked. Too bad, thought we had a connect. No sense dwelling makes, never been a more compelling case than the model covered in Lori yelling Mace, who fell from grace. 11 stories for storytelling, while the whore was...
Lori yelling Mace, who fell from grace, from storytelling... Horror is yelling. I mean, see that internal punchy rhyme scheme? The man just bends and bends and bends rhymes to his will. Is a will.
In a more compelling case than the model covered in Lori yelling Mace, who fell from grace. 11 stories for storytelling, while the whore was yelling Mace, the vocal cords were swelling.
For storytelling, but the whore was yelling rape. So Eminem saying she's just telling stories. She's lying over here. But she would probably be telling a different story with the obsessive compulsive assault driven shady that he's painting for us.
Covered in Lori yelling Mace, who fell from grace. 11 stories for storytelling, while the whore was yelling Mace, the vocal cords were swelling in a voice.
Oh my god, fell from grace, like you've fallen from grace, right? You've sinned. But in this case, like, grace could actually be falling from a building right now, and you hear her as she's like falling and being pushed off of a building. I mean, that
Lori yelling Mace, who fell from grace. 11 stories for storytelling, while the whore was rays of the vocal cords were swelling and a voice was more hoarse than Tory spelling space. Still, they swarm the gates of my fan.
Oh, he's relentless. He's fucking ruthless. I mean, Tory spelling. She is. She's kind of horsey. I mean, you could put a saddle on that and ride it.
But the whore was yelling, rays of the vocal cords were swelling and a voice was more hoarse than Tory spelling space. Still, they swarm the gates of my fancy estates to greet Norman Bates with a warm embrace. Let's your Andrew Yates. Don't ask me for a date.
To greet Norman Bates. Norman Bates, psycho killer from Psycho. And then Andrea Yates, real life psycho, who murdered all five of her children. She drowned them, didn't she? Yeah, she a crazy
place. Still, they swarm the gates of my fancy estates to greet Norman Bates with a warm embrace. Let's your Andrea Yates. Don't ask me for a date, don't delay. Well, the
Unless you're Andrea Yates. So basically, unless you're just a crazy psycho serial killer who murders your own children, I won't go out on a date with
you. On my fancy estates to greet Norman Bates with a warm embrace. Unless you're Andrea Yates, don't ask me for a date, though you're late. Well, the sentiment's great, but wait, think this been a mistake? You wanted to intimidate. I want to intimidate.
Intimidate. You want to have a nice cuddly time. I want to intimidate and assault
you. Well, the sentiment's great, but wait, think this been a mistake? You wanted to intimidate. I want to intimidate. I have infinite hate, and my blood is mainly cause of the game of... Wait, dinner at 8. I have infinite hate, and my blood is mainly cause of the...
You hear him get a text, he's like, wait, dinner at 8? Because he's about to say fuck off again, and instead he's like, oh, no, let's get back into it. Camera died, I'm coming right back. Sorry, guys, we're back.
Cause of the game of... Wait, dinner at 8. I have infinite hate...
Wasn't there a movie, Dinner at 8, about a cheating relationship? I think so.
And my blood is mainly cause of the
game of love.
I mean, wow, what a wild, trippy ride. But for me, it was the storytelling, right? Very, very smooth, complex rhyme schemes, great metaphors, and just great writing for both of them to not only tell a story, but tell a story that has a deeper meaning that relates to the love game that is known as hip-hop, that these two amazing MCs play and relate to hip-hop. I love Kendrick Lamar as a feature on that. I love that Kendrick Lamar added to the hook and really took that hook to another level with some smooth sort of sing-songy raps and vibes. Kendrick Lamar giving us the different personalities, right? When he left the voice message, giving us just some of that creativity and some of that spin on things. Yeah, he really suited this track with Shady. Like, I love the way that they blended together. It didn't really feel like a track where it's like, yeah, Kendrick needs to sit here and like try to rap with Eminem, like out rap Eminem. No, Kendrick was like, I'm gonna go be Kendrick. I'm gonna go sit in my own lane, because again, I don't think that you can necessarily compare them. And it's also hard to compare them because this is Eminem's track. Eminem got the first verse and then he got an extra long third verse. So you get a lot more Eminem to judge and a lot more Eminem to spin off of. And obviously if Eminem's gonna pull out like just crazy triples and quadruples left and right out of his ass and Kendrick's gonna go more storytelling mode, we're not really gonna compare on that. I loved it. I love the track as a whole. I love the vibe. I love the nostalgia brought into the new school, the new era with the hip hop. But man, I mean, some of those flows and switches and technicals. I'm gonna have to play this one again and enjoy it. Eminem, Kendrick Lamar, you were Knoxville certified. So if you guys like today's video, if you're here at the end, listen, obviously enjoying the content, do me a huge favor, support channel directly. These breakdowns are hard. They take a lot out of me, but I do them for you. I put in the grind, subscribe, notifications on, support channel. I love you guys. Stay safe, stay positive. This is Knoxville. Catch you again. I'm out.